These are my last goals before I start to prep for 2025. Hey y'all, it's Taylor from Tattoo Teacher Plans. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. So we're working on November goals today. We're also going to reflect on October and set weekly actions for the first week of November. I'm actually gonna do this week back here because, I mean, it's 3 days into November and I just wanna get like a good start on the month. But like I said, these are my last of the year. I like to spend December prepping for 2025. So I am doing my annual goals series this year. I haven't decided exactly when I want to upload those videos, but the first one will be up this week, either Wednesday or Thursday, I think. That's the plan right now. I will let you know on Instagram, and I'll post probably on the community tab here on YouTube with all the details on that. But it's something I've been doing for a while now. I really enjoy doing it. And I always get good feedback that it's like helpful for people. So I am excited to get into new goals. But before we can do that, we need to wrap up with November. So let's start with monthly reflections. I do these on my own and then we go over them together. I really like to spend a couple of sessions working on my reflections because things like come to my mind sometimes later, and I just like to jump around a little bit. So here we go. Biggest wins for October was getting some good sleep. My kittens, they are 6 months old now, almost 7 months old now, and they are finally starting to calm down a little bit at night, and that is nice. They like to sleep on top of me, but we're all getting better sleep now. My kitty Scout, she's doing okay too. She had her final blood work checkup to make sure that she was good to go, and she is. I got my budget under control finally. So from about May to September, things were not going well with my budget, but I'm back on track. I have also stepped up at work. I had a successful MoxiLife review and launch. I met my goals with all of that, which I'm very proud of myself. I'm seeking peace wherever and whenever I can. And Callie and I, my sister, we have decided to go on our trip finally. So not this summer, but next summer, we're going to be going to Scotland for sure, because my dad's side of the family is from Scotland. We have a castle there. It's a whole thing. And like most of our family has been there. And so we're excited to go and explore all of Scotland. We'll also probably pop down to London to see some shows because we are musical theater freaks. And we might also go over to Belgium to see our aunt. So obviously we have a lot of time to plan, which is good. We also have plenty of time to save up money and be debt-free on it. So I'm really excited. It's something to look forward to. Okay, things that are currently working. My budget, relationships, tracking my sleep and seeing trends with that, switching to every other week for my meal delivery, my diet, and my new cleaning schedule. Things that are currently not working, my stress level, specifically at work. Workouts are still not where I want them to be, not enough time outside, and I'm lacking a sense of community at work. That is a theme at work, like everyone is feeling that. So that's something I definitely want to work on building. And then just lacking some fun and recreation in life. What I learned this month, morning intentions are helpful. I need to be more active, especially with winter coming. I tend to get some seasonal depression, so I need to nip that in the bud. Change is scary, but it will be okay. And I am craving some fun. Journaling is good for me in small doses. That is key. Small doses, like once a week. In fact, I'm going to make that one of my goals for this month. Once a week and just something short and quick. Okay. Improvements or adjustments. Workouts, I'm going to start slower so I can find some success and momentum. Some kind of workout schedule. I haven't really worked out that yet, but I'm thinking I want to try that. And then I need to play more with my kittens at night because I need to wear them out so that when we go to bed, it's a little bit more restful for everybody. I was really good at that like during the summer when they were babies, but I just kind of, since school started, let that kind of fall off. What am I most grateful for right now? My family, my friends, my sweet nephews, Callie and Sam, which is my sister and brother-in-law, my home, my kitties, and my job, even though it's hard right now. Habits I want to nurture next month: my water intake, my workout schedule, skincare routine, check-ins at work better. I think I've figured out a way to do that. I want to check in with every single person every week, and I'm going to actually use the grade book in the back of my planner for that. And then continuing tracking my sleep, check in with my budget, and simple meal planning. I think that's kind of key for me right now. Nothing too complicated, nothing that's taking up too much time. And so this month, health and wellness is continuing to be a focus. So that was last month's, and I believe it was the month before as well. Yes, probably the month before. Yeah. Okay. So it's been an ongoing issue that I just can't seem to get any momentum on, but I'm hoping this month that I make some progress with that. Fingers crossed. Okay. Let me add a little bit more color to this, and we will be back to talk about monthly goals. Here we go. I did end up adding here time with my family. So I've mentioned this off and on a little bit, like little pieces of it, but my dad is retiring pretty soon, actually, from teaching and coaching. He's had some health issues, mainly his, he's got to get his hip replaced. And he just, like, things just came to a head. And he's like, I think that this is the end of the road for me. And I support that decision fully. And what's exciting about that is that my parents and my middle sister are going to be moving to my town, where I and my youngest sister live with her family. So it's going to be the next few months. Things are going to be moving a lot. And I'm excited. It's going to be really, really good. We haven't all been in the same place in 25 years, maybe. Yeah. I mean, it's going to be really, really, really good. Okay. But now we need to focus on November goals. I did tear the page a little bit here with my super sticky post-it notes, but that's okay. So for November goals, we're going to keep it pretty simple in some categories, and then you'll kind of see where I am putting my focus. So that's going to be in health and wellness and financial. But some of the other categories are going to have some pretty specific things in them. And I just want to, like, break some things down, kind of figure out why some things are not working for me anymore. But this month is just going to be like a bit of exploration of things to try, what's going to work, what's not working, things like that. So this month may look a little bit different from previous months. By the way, I do have my goal planning playlist down in the description if you want to see any other goal videos, or if you want to see my, like, annual goal series, the past versions of that. Okay, so we're going to start with personal, of course. So with personal, I'm really just going to grab a couple of things because this category is not a major focus for this month. So what I want to just kind of carry over from previous months is my self-care night and just kind of taking time each week to set aside specifically for self-care. And then the other thing is skincare. I've been getting really lazy with my skincare, and I am 40 now. So it's not something I need to be really skipping all the time. And that's what I feel like I've been doing. So that's just what I'm going to highlight this month. It's nothing crazy. It's nothing even that serious, but just some things to make me feel better and just kind of check off on this category. So my focus this month is going to be check in with myself. Now for both of these, I need a weekly tracker, and let's just go and check. I can't remember how many weeks are in this month. Okay, so I'm going to count five because I am going to count this previous week that includes some November days. So we're going to do five. Now fun and recreation. This is one that I have struggled with all year. I don't know why, but it's just been a struggle. It's just been one that I can't get a hold of. But I'm just going to do some very simple things this month. So I want to have a specific happy hour with my friends. It's something we like to do. We just chit chat. And then do some kind of sister date where we either go do something or we have a night in. Last month we did a movie night. It was super fun. We love a theme. So we did a themed movie night for Practical Magic. I made the food and everything and she showed up. It was super fun. So whatever we decide to do, I just want to do something with my sister. And I'm going to pull recharge here from my yearly focus. And neither one of those need trackers. So we're going to go straight on into work and learning. Now, school has been a struggle. I'm a high school teacher and instructional coach. It's just been a kind of a tough year. It's just been like hurdle after hurdle. But one thing that I have found that has been helping is to check in with every teacher every week. And I've been keeping track of that. And I just haven't done it consistently. So this month I want to make that a specific goal here. And then the other thing is I want to plan out my annual goal series and actually prep it and get it ready. I don't know if I'll get everything ready, but I'll at least try to get it ready. There's four videos that's going to go into this, so I can at least get halfway through and at least have everything planned out. And my focus is going to be support. And I need trackers for this one. Okay, next is family and relationships. We just had a really good fall weekend together. It was great. Okay, so I want to carry over with like calling my parents every week. But also this month, my dad is getting his hip replaced, his other hip. And I'm going to go down for Thanksgiving. We were all going to have Thanksgiving up here where I live. But since his surgery got moved up, I'm going to go down and help with all of that. I might even bring back a load of stuff that my parents want me to keep in my garage and just kind of help out around the house and cook and everything. So another thing is spending time with my nephews. I love them so much. There's three of them now and they're just the cutest. They're just the best. I love them so much. So my focus this month, I think I'm going to do connection. I think we'll go connection. So I'm also going to add in here my cousin Lauren. She is turning 40. We were 6 months apart and we basically grew up together. So I just want to be sure to call her or text her or something just to make that day special for her. I don't know that I'll get to see her, but maybe. Okay, so let's go to health and wellness. Now, like I said, this is one of my focuses for this month. So I just want to be sure to outline a few things, but also keep it simple because I've not been creating my own motivation. I'm struggling in this category and I don't know why it has been so difficult. It's just like, it's been a struggle, like mentally. Like physically I'm fine. It's just like, I can't seem to get it together to make any progress. So for this category, here's what I'm going to just kind of break down. And this is going to seem really simple, but if I can get these things under control, then we could step it up from here. So one, I'm going to meal plan. So I'm stepping back from getting meal delivery every single week to every other week just to save a little money. And I feel like I'm in a good spot with my diet to do that. I'm also going to continue to track my sleep because that seems to be motivating for me. I'm also going to do 3 workouts a week. I know that doesn't seem like much, but I'm creating a habit and then I can up it from there once I build that habit. And then my water intake, I've been a little lazy with my water lately and I have to keep my kidneys happy or they get real angry at me. So focus this month is I want to do something with like creating habits. Let's do building habits. Now I need trackers for all of these. Those are some wonky dots, but that's fine. Okay, spiritual and personal growth has also been a struggle this whole year. And I think I've just been distracted by a lot of different things that I haven't really focused on this category. But I want to switch things up a little bit this week. I've been doing like reflection in here, which has been great. And I've kind of created that habit. But this month I want to try journaling one time a week. Because I'm doing the reflection pretty much on my own. So I'm just going to sub in journaling once a week. And I think, like, I'm actually enjoying journaling now, which is crazy. I did not think that would happen, but it has. So I just want to keep track of doing that and see how that helps or doesn't. I don't know. And then, of course, I'll keep my daily gratitude as well. My focus for this month is going to be get out of your head. And I need trackers for both. Now, financial, got quite a few things here. Okay, so for financial, I've already mentioned that I'm doing my meal delivery every other week now. I'm also going to continue updating my budget at least 3 times a week, if not more. And then I've been really enjoying my monthly review and just like kind of pointing out to myself where I can make some changes. And then I'm also going to build my savings a little bit and pay off my credit card because that just needs to happen. And I like to keep it a zero balance, but that doesn't always happen every month. So these are all pretty simple things, but I think they can make a big difference. And I'm going to pull in this for my annual goals, healthy relationship with money. Most of the things this month are coming from this little section, but that's jumping out at me. A few of these need trackers. And then finally, physical environment. So this one, again, we're keeping it pretty simple. Now, I was looking through my things to consider list. Let me find it. This one right here. This helps me like just like jog my memory and stuff. And in here it says pets. So this is where I'm going to plug in playing with the kittens. Well, the cats, I guess they're all getting a little older. And just kind of like focusing on weekdays because I'm really good with them on weekends. But just setting aside some time for them. And then I want to decorate for Christmas, but I don't know how because I have these crazy kittens who are just absolutely crazy sometimes, like right now. And I don't know that I can put up a tree this year, but I just want to like find a few things. Maybe even go to Home Goods. We just got a Home Goods where I live. People are going nuts for it. But maybe just go by and see if there's a couple things I can add to my collection. And then just continuing my weekly and daily cleaning. For my focus, I'm going to do tidy and clutter free. Okay, so trackers, really just these bottom two. We have monthly goals done. I'm going to put this off to the side. I'm really glad that I'm going to hopefully be in one book next year instead of two because the coil on the new planner is like so much bigger. Like the size difference is crazy. So fingers crossed, I can just be in one planner. Okay, so this is done. Now we're gonna go over here. I know that seems weird, but this is the week of October 28th through November 3rd. So we're getting into November. Why not go ahead and start the goals now, you know? Why not? And I think since this is like the week of Halloween, let's do some Halloween colors. I think that'll be fun. Okay, so we are over here. So for personal, I'm just going to grab both of the things that I wrote because I need to be tracking those every week. And actually, I'm going to grab one of these big paper clips just so I don't have to go back and forth. And then fun and recreation. I don't know. I'm going to put ideas for our sister time. Work and learning. I need to check in with everybody and I need to start planning out my goal series. Like I need to figure out the dates. Family and relationships. So I need to call my parents And I need to contact my cousin
for her birthday.
Okay, now health and wellness. Got quite a few things on this list, but I need all of them. And I'm hoping that I'm going to get a good start this week. Spiritual and personal growth. I'm going to grab both of those as well. And financial. So I'm not doing... Am I doing meal delivery this week? No, I'm not doing meal delivery this week. So we're going to leave that one off. I do need to update my budget. And I can't do the rest of it yet. Okay. So just the one. And then physical environment. I need to do my weekly and daily cleaning and play with the kitties. I'm not going to worry about decorating just yet. Weekly actions are ready to go for the week. Only thing I like to do to finish things up is go ahead and put in my weekly reflection stickers. Now next year, I'm not going to have to worry about that because you can see here on the weekly actions pages, they're already kind of set up for you. So if you can see that, it's already kind of divided up, which is really nice. And you have all of the information you need for journaling and all of that at the bottom, which I love that change. That's an excellent change. But until then, I need to set up my weekly actions. So I'm going to do this real quick and I'll be right back. And there we go. Okay, so today we worked on monthly reflections. We got November goals all ready to go. And then we also set up weekly actions for the first week of November. I'm so ready for November. October was a busy one. It was a lot to deal with. And I'm ready to start fresh. Let's finish this year strong. Let me know how your goals are going. What are you excited for at the end of the year? And what are you excited for next year? Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. Hit that notification bell if you want to be notified when I upload. And share this video with somebody you think might like it. And I'll see you next time. Bye!